Here we go again then for another round of Grand Prix action. The conditions are just right to spice up the racing in this part of the world today, and we're all itching to get underway. We're northeast of Budapest for the race today at the 2.7-mile Hungaroring circuit. 14 corners here, 8 to the right and 6 to the left, on a track where downforce is king and passing is notoriously difficult. A tough race in store then for our drivers today, so tell me, Anthony Davidson, what will you be looking out for as the cars make their way down into Turn 1?
Well, first of all, let's hope that everyone's well behaved and we can have a nice incident-free start. That initial release is going to be the most interesting thing. The clean side of the grid will be better rubbered in, so keep an eye out for cars over there potentially making their way through.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. Kimi Raikkonen starts today from pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Verstappen, Valtteri Bottas, and Vettel, Sainz, Alonso, Hülkenberg, and Esteban Ocon, Grosjean, Magnussen, Sergio Perez, and Van Dorn, Leclerc, Gasly, Brendan Hartley, and Sergei Sirotkin. Ericsson and Lance Stroll rounds off the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
You should have some space going into the first corner, so try to keep it tidy. Launch map is good, but we need to learn the gears, so go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the softs. DRS is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Okay, copy that. We're boxing this lap. Give us the best in-lap you can. Remember, box this lap. Keep an eye on your distance to the speed limit line as you approach and make sure you don't speed. Release. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires. Thank you. Let's turn up the ERS deployment and burn some of this energy. Sebastian is in the pits. The car behind has come in. They're now on the soft tyre. Softs on the car behind. Gap to the car in front is 3.3 seconds. speed gap behind us is 2.7 seconds. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. We're leading our teammate by 7.1 seconds. The gap to the car behind is 5.2 seconds. 5 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, update on the car for you. Tyres are looking very nice. Shouldn't have to worry about the wear too much right now. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, clear. Yellow flag. Gap to teammate behind is 7.3 seconds. Gap behind is 5.5 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
Here's our winner, pulling their Ferrari into Parc Fermé. What a fantastic race it was. And Anthony Davidson, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
So, here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari, on the top step once more. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Sergio Perez. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
That's it for today's Grand Prix. And from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.